it's quite. I read this story in a book a couple of years ago, which I really liked. And it goes that once Krishna and Arjuna went and visited one man's house. This man was considered to be a bad man, and he had lots and lots of money. And what happened was, he even treated Krishna and Arjuna badly. But when Krishna and Arjuna left, Lord Krishna blessed him with an even greater fortune. So Arjuna was pretty flummoxed, you know. He said, "My God, Krishna is behaving very funny." Then they went to another house of a poor man, and the only possession this man had was a cow. And he treated them so well, even though he had nothing. He was so hospitable, so kind, so warm. And it really moved Arjuna. So when Krishna and Arjuna left this man's house, Lord Krishna told the man, "My blessing is that I'm going to even take away your cow." So Arjuna was foxed. When they went away from the man's house, he said, "What kind of behavior is this, Lord Krishna? I mean, you know, you're blessing that man with a fortune who already has so much, and this man, poor fellow, has one cow, and you're taking that also away." So Lord Krishna told Arjuna that my blessing to the man who has a lot of fortune is more fortune, because he is already so attached that I'm giving him more attachments. So it's actually a curse. And the nice man who was poor had only one attachment, so what greater blessing can I give him than taking that last attachment away from him?" So then Arjuna realized what the jnani, what Krishna was trying to show him. My understanding is that actually the curse was not a curse on the bad man. It was probably a blessing in disguise, because as it is, the man was stuck in the Maya, had so many attachments. So by heaping attachments and attachments on him, eventually the man would realize at some point the futility of attachment, and then the process of seeking would begin. Because we are so attached to so many things around us, be it objects, be it people, be it our own thoughts and emotions, these are all attachments to things. And there's no end to how much one can be attached to the things around us, the people around us, our own thoughts, our own emotions. And the understanding is that their journeys, the good boy, the good man, the so-called bad man, ultimately they are all heading to the same destination. And that is a destination where there's a realization that objects are not who we are in our true essence. We derive a sense of self from objects. And what Lord Krishna is trying to show is that by taking away the attachment to objects, then you realize who you truly are, because you are not that which you derive your sense of self from. So this story actually shows how a jnani can work in mysterious ways. It may appear that he is, being unfair, but actually there is full compassion behind his act.